Well, you can understand it's no wonder that many of my fellow journalists, their friends, and their families wish that they could forget the year 2018. Let's run through the numbers to understand a little bit better. Reporters Without Borders says that 80 journalists have been killed so far this year. Now, that's 15 more than last year, and it makes 2018 the most lethal on record. Most of the deaths happened in Afghanistan, Syria, Yemen, India. You see right there, the United States joined this black list and comes in fifth place for the first time. Now, the number of jailed journalists has increased, standing at 348 tonight. Most imprisonments taking place in China, Egypt, Turkey, Iran, and Saudi Arabia. Well, how did the world become so hostile to journalists? And what can be done to reverse this trend? That's a lot to talk about tonight, and I'm happy to welcome back to the day Christian Mier. He is head of Reporters Without Borders, Germany. Christian, it's good to have you back on the show. Why do so many people hate us and the work that we do?
Well, very often I see in lots of countries all over the world, we see a hostile climate towards journalists. We see corrupt governments who are involved in organized crime. And last but not least, we see lots of fragile states where actually the state is not anymore visible or in power, but where organized crime took over power.
Your report does not directly point the finger at U.S. President Donald Trump, but the report does state that expressions of hatred legitimize violence. And, you know, that immediately makes me think of Trump always using that phrase, enemy of the people.
Yeah, of course. What we see working globally, that if you go to Cambodia, for example, if you go to Philippines, countries where threats to journalists are almost on a daily basis happening, and that the president of the Philippines and the president of Cambodia, they themselves, they refer to President Donald Trump. Right. If he says, label journalists enemy of the people, we could do so as well. And so you cannot, I think, directly link any killings of journalists to what Donald Trump says. But at least, I mean, it gives legitimacy to a hostile climate, and not only in these countries, but lots of countries all over the world.
And we've seen that right here in Germany as well, haven't we?
Yeah, unfortunately, we saw in Germany this year a rising number of threats against journalists, physical threats against journalists who have been reporting about right-wing demonstrations. And I think there are lots of people who somehow feel comfortable in a climate which makes this criticism, and it's not only criticism, this even threats and this violence against journalists a legitimate thing. And I think this is really a worrisome trend.
I mean, there's this word that is thrown out, you know, on a regular basis now, Lügenpresse, you know, the lying press. And I mean, a few years ago, that would have been unheard of to say that word in public.
Yeah, and that is really worrying. I think with 6-7 years ago, you always would have used it with spelling marks. And now currently it's more or less used almost on a daily normal basis by critical people, even if it's ironic, but it's a Nazi term. Mm-hmm. And I think you have to be aware of, and if it's shouted on demonstrations and used as a term against the work of journalists, this is a worrisome trend, even if we mourn in Germany. Unfortunately, we don't have to mourn for any deaths against journalists.
That's a very good point. We're fortunate in that regard. Do you think, Christian, do we carry part of the blame for this dramatic downturn in public opinion regarding our work?
I mean, journalists are not saints, and maybe there have been some times in the past where the phrase objectivity was somehow misunderstood as something that journalists would not make any failures. But journalists are human beings, and I think objectivity is nothing which exists, I would say. Mm-hmm. But there's always an approximation to objectivity.
Yeah, the pursuit of it.
I mean, this was maybe journalists haven't been always honest with themselves and to the public, and this is at least maybe one point. Mm-hmm. But of course, we have as well a changing media environment as well, which makes it more easier to distribute hatred and to shout out loudly. So I think, unfortunately, it's a mixture of different patterns.
You know, just before Reporters Without Borders released this annual report, Margaret Sullivan, the media columnist at The Washington Post, she came out with a strong critique of the media. And we've got an excerpt here I want to read for you. She writes that the news media continues, even now when it should know better, to be addicted to both sides' journalism. In the name of fairness, objectivity, and respect for the office of the U.S. presidency, it still seems to take Trump at his word while knowing full well that his word is not good. When major news organizations publish tweets and news alerts that repeat falsehoods merely because the president uttered them, then it becomes, she says, journalistic malpractice. I mean, that's a strong critique. Is she right?
Maybe I don't share all the concerns, but she has one point to that extent, which I see a worrying trend as well, because there are people who say we see a revival of quality journalism in the US because there are rising subscription numbers of New York Times and things like this. But as well, I see something which I think is a bit worrying, but that journalists in the US somehow turn out being activists, but activists against a president who is hostile towards journalists, towards liberal democracy. Mm-hmm. And this turns journalists somehow towards activists like we know it from dictatorships, even mm-hmm. without comparing not at all the US with any dictatorships. But it's always a problem if journalists, when journalists become activists, because journalist's role is not an activist, but someone who describes a part of the reality.
Yeah, I mean, that's a good point. And it's not just an American dilemma. I mean, you can consider, for example, when we report here in Germany about the far right, the AfD, or reporting about the Polish government, the Hungarian government, what's going on there. I mean, tell me if you agree with this, our respect for the office of prime minister or the office of president, it sometimes actually gets in the way of us doing our job.
Yeah, of course, and I can understand the journalistic behavior to some extent, because if the people who you have to take into account, and if you have to held accountable, and that's the role of the journalist, as if they question actually the profession as such, I can understand this change of role. But I think journalists have to keep distance, and I think we have to be careful, journalists, because this in the end will lead to more loss of credibility, and then it becomes dangerous.
And let's hope that the report for 2019 will be better than the report for 2018. Christian Mier, head of Reporters Without Borders, Germany. Christian, as always, we appreciate it. Thank you.